Hello, I'm David Duchovny. No, I'm not. Hello, I'm Robert Sheehan. I've been brought here against my will. I just want to say, if my family sees this, I'm at UCD in South Dublin. Please, please come and rescue me.
Just leave a bag of €2 million in unmarked notes down in the CTN locker. But leave it anonymous.
You can't put a price on love, can you? Can you? Please?
We just watched Patrick Stewart's quadruple take challenge online.
Yeah, just lecturing to the world about how to do a quadruple take. He thinks he has the monopoly on quadruple takes. But you do not, Patrick Stewart.
You're not even very good at it.
In fact, it was very clumsy and you lost count halfway through.
So you were presenting Best Comedy?
I was. I'm a very serious man, so I think that's why they did it, you know, for irony purposes. I think that's what the concept of irony is. I'm not quite sure.
I don't know. I've only ever learned it from listening to Alanis Morissette, so I'm...
Neil Gaiman would be more famous for Stardust, and he wrote Coraline, and he wrote an amazing book called American Gods, and another one called Neverwhere. He's just the fucking shit.
So you're reading...
As they say in the ghetto.
You got a new film out. Would you like to tell us about it?
No, I wouldn't.
So I play Clary, whose best friend is Simon.
Yeah.
Who's
secretly harboring feelings of love
for
his
me.
Best friend. Romance
love.
Love.
Romance.
Romantic lovely love.
I'm like her best friend, but who is secretly harboring feelings of love for her. And non-friend love, sexy love. I want her to be my love girlfriend, my lover.
Come into my city of bones.
Exactly, yeah. Look, you went to his city of bones, you never saw mine.
Yeah.
So when you found out that you were going to play Simon, did you have any reservations or were you just really, really excited?
You know, I like to go to restaurants that you don't need a reservation, so I didn't have any reservations, you know, as regards in the culinary sense.
How was it from changing from Misfit that you were more like a strong personality to Simon that is more naive?
It basically required me to do less with my limbs. Less of this.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And more of this, just being stood stock still, trying to look as normal as humanly possible. That
you
was always the challenge.
I liked all the stuff with me, Lily and Jamie, where there's a little bit of frisson between myself and Jay's character. I liked all that stuff because, you know, I really got to exercise my sardonic muscles in that one. Well, you know, what they don't do in Twilight is that everyone's looking at everyone else, you know what I mean? Don't think I haven't noticed Jamie Campbell Bower's sculpted bum. Look at that thing, it's like a peach. Yeah, Alanis Morissette is very much the queen of irony. It's when you've got 10,000 spoons, but all you need is a knife. What kind of situation are you in if all you need is a knife? Maybe you're in a POW camp. And you've dug a tunnel, but then there are two guards on the other end of the tunnel, and all you have to do is kill them, and then you're away to freedom. And you have 10,000 spoons, and then you've dug the tunnel with them, and all you need is a knife to kill the other two, the Chinese prisoners.
I was talking with Jamie about this movie, and we can't decide whether to call it The Mortal Instruments, or City of Bones, or The Mortal Bones, or The City of Instruments, or what exactly do you call it?
Well, I call my genitals The Mortal Instruments.
Not City of Bones?
Yeah. No, that's when me and a bunch of mates get together. Thank you.
I'd love the ability to be able to see flatulence so that as soon as whoever does it, you know, you can blame them straight away. They can't deny
like
that
someone
it was
weeing
them.
In a pool.
Exactly, but that's a little bit, you know, that's a bit clearer, but you know, when you see someone
in, so depending on how you look at it.
Depends on the quality of the urine.
Indeed.
Keep reading books.
Books are awesome.
Books are awesome. Books are a far more gratifying piece of art than a film is. But you can then go see the film after you've read the book, right? So read The Mortal Instruments, you bunch of thicks. You know, all the badass Shadowhunters had to come in and get, you know,
lots and lots of runes and ink on their skin, which required, you know, 2 hours before filming of sitting in a makeup chair going, please, I just want to sleep. Whereas I was asleep. I was at home in bed.
And you could do the out of bed look. And
exactly, yeah. Exactly. The more normal I looked, the better. So if anything, you know, I just ate whatever I wanted and breezed in.
You had to basically drink at night, come in hungover so you'd look the part.
Exactly, exactly. Come in barely wearing a shirt and trousers if the rest of them were lucky.
There's a scene where you take your top off and we see, yeah, you know, girls, we really take care of that, you're kind of fit. So is your character
That's just one of my nipples. I have several.
You have more than two?
I have about seven, all going down my back on either side.
Oh, that's not sexy, Robert. That's not sexy.
But you haven't seen it yet. And you're welcome to.
I'm very much like Jean-Claude Van Damme in the sense that in my contract it's stipulated that I have to show my arse. Like full on, full moon. Yeah, I've been calling it the whole thing because I don't know what to call it. I've been adding all the words in their right order.
Just a bit of a mouthful. We arrived at Cobb.
Cobb. Doesn't that sound like an 80s detective show on the BBC? Cobb. Or like, you know, Touch of Frost. Urban fantasy, I heard it being described as recently, which I quite liked, urban fantasy. You know what I mean? It made me think of like Gandalf in some skinny jeans, popping pills in a rave somewhere, you know what I mean?
Around South London.
Gandalf and Professor Xavier, like, smashing it. Taking MDMA in like some warehouse in Brixton. But it's not like that at all. Neither Gandalf nor Patrick Stewart are in it, sadly.
All right, here's my version. Because I think you can't notice what you've seen the first time, or even maybe the second.
There's an actor's theory behind it.
Give it somewhere to go. You know what I mean? Right. Okay. Okay. You watching Patrick?
Oh, did you go to do five there?
I'm not quite at the end, but I've read on. I've spoiled it for myself a wee bit. I know how super, super natural and sleek and sexy I get. Ladies.
We were on a street one day, just in a quiet kind of neighborhood area, and loads of fans showed up. And I was going, how do they know where we are? Are they paying like a... Do they have a mole on the inside? No, I don't have any tattoos.
Why not?
You know, I wish I had one tucked away somewhere that I couldn't show you, but I'm being absolutely honest. I have no ink. I'm pure as the driven snow, darling.
And do you now have
I like the camera just went like that. What are you going down into my cleavage for a minute? Do you want to see a little bit? See a little bit of bum there? I quite like that film Duets, which was basically an out-and-out failure of a film, but I loved it. Because there was karaoke, and that makes every situation better.
Did you enjoy the shooting?
Yeah.
You all the time look at my...
You've got fantastic hair.
Yeah, I know, it's big.
You look like, you know, you're ready to go to the pageant.
Yeah, I knew you would love it, because you have that curly thing going on, but it's not so cool as my afro.
You could get lost in there for days.
Yeah, definitely.
I'd like to, in fact.
Friend zone is a tragic, tragic place to be. And, you know, you should do anything and everything to get out of the friend zone if you find yourself there. Students, you should all be listening to this. Because if you find yourself in the friend zone, do the quickest thing you can to get out of it. And that might involve jumping up on the nearest table and getting your willy out and swinging it around in circles. Because that will certainly remove you from any friend zone and put you firmly in an enemy zone.
Loner zone.
For most people, loner zone, exactly. Pariah zone. You know, the premiere being on the side of the road adds a certain tension to the whole thing. Look at you with the runes on your arms. You're gorgeous.
She has the costume.
That's lovely. Oh yeah, you're Isabel. That's lovely. I just had tea delivered. Yeah, Simon and Isabel have a little thing later on in the films. Can I have your number? Yeah, sweet. Success. Okay, let's wrap this up.
Are you excited to film those scenes with Jemima and like develop that?
By the mouth, yeah. Sorry, there's a whole different dialogue going on this interview.
What is your three top tips to get a bit more kind of like kick-ass spirit in you, like your character?
I think draw runes on yourself because you know what, tattoos are cool. chicks dig tattoos, and you know, they probably have magical powers.
And B, get a tattoo.
Get a tat.
Right, hang on, okay. Just you slip over.
Okay.
That's it.
High five. That's how you do it, Patrick Stewart.
Yeah. Learn from this, Patrick. Learn.
And check out another weekly update on showbizgeek.com sometime next year. Thank you, Rob.
Pleasure.
Thank you very much, Robert.
Love.
Bye.
Silence.